And welcome to Roger Bacon's Ron Vakevich Stadium for tonight's action between the St. Bernard and Elmwood Place Titans and the North Kellogg Hill Trojans, and it is also the home of St. Bernard. Hello, I am Bill Bretz. I'm glad you joined us tonight. It's ICR Saturday Night Football. That's right. We both, these teams are playing on Saturday night. We're actually starting around 6 o'clock or so on a Saturday night, too. So interesting start time. It is senior night here for St. Bernard. They are honoring 13 seniors, their largest senior class they've had in quite a long time. Matter of fact, I believe the largest one since they've had their football program back. So we've got two teams from Miami Valley Conference Grade Division tonight. It is a league game for both of these teams. North College Hill comes in game 1-0. St. Bernard comes in 1-1. But both of them have had a common opponent so far. North College Hill last week beat Cincinnati College Prep 22-20 in a nail biter in that game. St. Bernard lost to Cincinnati College Prep 2 weeks ago, 26-22. But they came back last week with a 26-0 win over Cincinnati Country Day. Let's look now tonight at tonight's key players for each time. We're going to start with North College Hill. And when you think of North College Hill, you got to think of number 6, Miles Landrum. He is a senior running back. He also plays defense back, does kickoff returns. Last year, he was a dual threat, running threat, with Cameron Williams. Miles Landrum had 1,535 yards last year, 11 touchdowns. Williams had 15 touchdowns of 1,123 yards. But this year, it's going to be a little bit different for Miles. It's in the first game of the season, which was actually a scrimmage game, Cameron Williams was hurt, and he's out for the season now. So a lot is going to be on the shoulders of this senior this year at North College Hill, because the dual threat's not there. He is the threat now as running back. So for St. Bernard, you got to go with number 2, Zakeem Hundley. He's also a senior. This guy does everything. He's a quarterback, defensive back, punt returner, kickoff returner. He's one of those guys that never leads the field there. He could have been, last year, one of the best wide receivers in the city, but Coach Mike Corson needed a quarterback this year. Hundley was the most athletic. He stepped in at that position, and that is where he is as quarterback. But he's also great in defensive back. He has great hands. As he said, he was a great receiver last year. He plays defensive back this year. In the first two games of the season, he's had 4 interceptions. So he is a threat in the backfield and a threat as quarterback. Keys for the game tonight. Well, for St. Bernard, it's going to be stop the running game. Well, now they only have to focus on one guy. That would be Miles Landrum. But they need to stop that running game against the because North College Hill can run it. They have a great offensive line. They can run it right down the hill right now. And it is senior night. And this is Mike Corson's largest group of seniors he's had in his 4 years here at St. Bernard. They had 13 seniors introduced here pregame. And so it is a big night for the seniors. The last 3 times these teams have met, and they've only met 3 times since St. Bernard started their program back about 9-10 years ago, North College Hill's won big. But this year it could be a little bit different here. For North College Hill now, their keys right now. Well, they're starting a freshman quarterback tonight. That's right. Since Williams is out right now, they're going to be starting number 22, Jalen Turnage. He is a 5'10", 175-pound freshman. He is going to get his baptism under fire here tonight in this game. And they have 2 other freshmen on the offensive line. So for North College Hill, this freshman's got to step up. And they run the spread offense. And you know how important the spread offense is with running and receiving. That's got to click for the Trojans to win tonight. Both those receivers, they have 4 good receivers out there, and of course Miles Landrum in the backfield. North College Hill is coached by David Poole. He's in his first year, and Mike Corson, as we mentioned, is the coach for St. Bernard, and he is in the 4th year. Both these coaches well known in this area. We'll be talking about them throughout the game here tonight. So, with that, we will be starting kickoff here, an early kickoff on a Saturday evening here, and it's not a bad evening. It's supposed to rain a little bit later on, but we're hoping the rains will hold off here tonight so we can get this game in tonight. It is senior night for St. Bernard. the Titans versus the Trojans. Kickoff coming up.
Looking for future leaders we can believe in? Look no further than the high school student athletes right here in Ohio. High school sports teach young people how to be effective leaders. It includes learning to listen, accepting responsibility, being a good role model, and it's about respect. The result, it transcends sports. It gives us hope for the future. This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Ohio Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
Question. When you walk into the boardrooms of the most successful companies here in Ohio, who do you meet? Answer, men and women who played high school sports. Education-based high school sports give us more than athletes we can root for. They give us leaders we can depend on. Question, so where will we find tomorrow's leaders? Answer, high school sports.
This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Ohio Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
The year was 1907. The Cubs won the World Series and the Ford Model R hit the assembly line. While here in Ohio, school administrators came together to form the Ohio High School Athletic Association. One thing that hasn't changed since 1907 is the dedication of the OHSAA to education-based athletics in Ohio. School sports teach responsibility, sportsmanship, and life lessons that stay with students long after their playing days are over. The OHSAA seeks to prepare students not for the next level of sport, but for the next level of life.
Well, yeah, there's some old prescription pills, but my son's a good kid. He's not going to look for them.
Two-thirds of teens who abuse opioids get them from friends and family. Don't live in denial, Ohio. Dispose of your leftover pills.
Both teams have taken the field. We're just about ready to get the season underway.
ICRC Friday Night Football. We are back here.
Breaks a tackle at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Vikings!
Side. He's looking for Hughes.
He got
has the separation.
Touchdown!
And Bill Brett's back here at Braun Bezovich Stadium, where it will be the Titans and the Trojans tonight in Miami Valley Conference action on here on Saturday night. Glad you have joined us. Our officials tonight, our referee is Frederick Brent Linger, umpire Kevin Sinners, linesman James Marshall, line judge is Thomas Shavinsky, and back judge is Mike Reed. So as we said, we're in the Miami Valley Conference here. Now, neither one of these teams have really a kicking game. You're going to see, after touchdowns, a lot of two-point conversions. St. Bernard has a player who has had kicking last year, Trevor Fleck, who's a senior. He was 3-for-6 last year in PATs, but neither team has tried a PAT yet this year. So you're going to see a lot of two-point conversions, and that could be an interesting issue right now. Last week in their game with North College Hill, that game was won. The Trojans won that game last week, largely on a couple of late touchdowns. So that was by Detre Jones. He had a fourth quarter kickoff return for 48 yards, and later in the quarter he had a 12-yard run for the go-ahead touchdown. So they won that game late in the fourth quarter last week. St. Bernard, as I said, coming off a shutout here. St. Bernard, over the years, last year they had 4 wins. That's their most wins they've had since they brought the program back. They brought the program back around 2011-2012. So, but we're about ready to kick this off, and it's going to be, you're going to see Jaden Wood kicking off for the Titans. Back to receive is Stanford Landrum and DeVos. And the kick, and it's not a bad kick. And it's touched by a Trojan at about this 19-yard line and then quickly taken out of bounds. So that was number 7 at Sincere DeVos, picked up the ball. He got a part of the ball there, tipped it a little bit, then picked it up and got about 4 yards back. So the Trojans will go to work here tonight, and we're going to see that freshman quarterback, Jalen Turnage, already. 5'10", 175-pound freshman. Now, you're going to have to excuse me tonight, but the numbers on North College are a little hard to see at times here. They are gold on white. That's not the best color combination here. Brown and white are the colors here for the St. Bernard. Turnage now under center on the first play. Man in motion. And the pitch, and we have a quick whistle here. I think we might have motion on, yep, we do have a motion call on North College Hill. That could be understandable here with a freshman quarterback, new quarterback. They lose 5 yards back to about the 20-yard line. And it's going to set up first and 15 now. We'll replay that first game. Turnage under center. And in motion, the pitch is to number 3, that's Jalen Stanford, and he gets back to about the line of scrimmage, where the Titans take him down. Here's a look at that play again. They just strung him out a little bit too much, got tripped up a little bit in the backfield, but then it was enough to bring him down. So it's now 2nd and 15 for the Trojans. Is in the shotgun. Still man in motion. And this one is at blown up in the backfield by St. Bernard. Karam Wagner was the ball carrier for North College Hill, and it was Jaden Wood. He's the one that's... They lost 5 on that play. He's the one who made the tackle. So now it's 3rd and long now. Trojans are going backwards, not forward. Turner's back to pass, and he's brought down about the 3-yard line. Brought down, look, by number... looks like number 3, Jaden Wood, was the one who brought him down. And he lost big time in that. And North College Hill started at around the 26-yard line. And they're now all the way back to the 3-yard line where they're going to have to punt. Mark Anderson, a sophomore punter, is going to be standing in the end zone now. Parker and Hundley back. And the ball is over, snapped over the head, and that is going to be a safety. So St. Bernard takes a 2-0 lead on the safety on a bad snap. We'll see this again. He wasn't even close. It's like 2 feet above his head. So 2-0 at 9:52 to go in this game. So a tough break on North College Hill as they had 0 yardage on their first possession there. As a matter of fact, they had a lot of minus yardage, and then to cap it off, a bad snap on the punt, bringing up the safety, and St. Bernard with a 2-0 lead. As I said, these two teams have played 3 times over the last few years, and North College Hill has won big each time, including 48-22 last year. And As far as I know, I don't think St. Bernard's ever had a lead in one of these games. So now free kick now by the Spartans, and Titans are going to get good field position. 50-yard line. That's Hundley. 45, 40, inside the 40, down to about the 37-yard line. He had about a 20-yard run back here for Zakeen Hundley. And Titans are going to have great field position in North College Hill territory right now. See that athleticism of Zakeen Hundley. He's a 6'2", 180-pound senior. They will run a spread offense, too. They have four receivers that they show down here, Wood, Page, Carroll, and Parker. And Lenny Thornton, he's in the backfield. He's number 30. And the give is to number 33. And he is pushed back.
Kevin Benford.
That's Kevin Benford. Number 23, Kevin Benford. You also see Benford in the backfield along with Greg Miller. Both of them are seniors. Said Mike Corson said this is the most seniors he's had since he's been coaching here. And this group has been playing together pretty much since their freshman year. So might say this is the most experience the Titans have had in quite a long time. Second and 8. Low snap. Give is to Thornton. Thornton gets a little bit of running room, tripped up down to about the 25-yard line. He's going to be about a yard or two short. See where his knee went down. That's where the mark will be going. They're marking at the 26. So it'll be second and 3. Again, without substantial kickers on either team, this would definitely be four down territory for the Titans if they need it. Man in motion. Fake. Hundley keeps it. He gets the first down to about the 20-yard line. So new set of downs here for the Titans. I'm going to say he's at the 21-yard line, but that's enough for a first down. Hundley has an offensive line of Alex Barron, James Cooper, Armand Kahn, Trevor Fleck, Brandon West, Jaden Wood, Jaden Page, Jason Carroll, and Jalon Parker are the receivers. And we said Lenny Thornton in the backfield along with Greg Miller and Kevin Benford will be sharing time back there. And the give is to Thornton. Thornton is grabbed in the backfield by number 53, Christian Stanley. And that slowed him up enough that he only gained about a yard. So it's his second and 9. Coach Hill will have Timothy Smith, Kristen Stanley there, your down lineman, Sincere DeBose, TJ Wood, for your ends, Trey Jones, great game last week, James Briggins, there are your linebackers, Stanford, Landrum, DeBose, Braxton, and Joy are your defensive backs, second and 9 now for the Titans. Hundley, low snap, he picks it up though. We'll get maybe back to about line of scrimmage. He might have lost about half a yard on that one, but it was a low snap. Did a good job of controlling that snap. Smith in with the tackle. He's one of those defensive linemen up front, 6'2", 220-pound senior for North College Hill. Each team has 5 players going both ways. And really, you know, considering on this level, where North College Hill is Division 5 and St. Bernard Division 6, that's not that many players, really. So these players do have some depth on their team. Third down now. They lost a yard on that one, so it's 3rd and 10. See if Hundley goes to the air. And we got a quick whistle here, either encroachment or... or a possession call. Looks like it's going against the Titans, so they're backing up now, back to the 26-yard line. So. Now sets up about 3rd and 15. He's going to see if Hundley goes to the air. He does. He lobs it up into the end zone, and that is caught by Jaden Wood. 26-yard TD pass from Hundley to Wood. That was a fantastic catch by Wood. In between two North College Hill defenders. Watch how he takes this ball, basically. Grabs it out of the air. Look at that. Great catch. Into the end zone, 26 yards. Hunley the Wood, that's Hunley's fourth TD of the year. That's Wood's third TD of the year, fourth TD pass of the year. He's his favorite receiver. He came in with 10 receptions. He only had 13. He got 10 of them. And now they're going for the two-point conversion. Hunley. And he is. It's intercepted, but that does not. It's not a run back on a two-point conversion. So two-point conversion is no good. But the Trojans, or the Titans, have an 8-0 lead here with 6:31 to go here in the first quarter. So they strike with a Hunley the Wood touchdown pass of 26 yards.
We would like to thank Cincinnati Children's Hospital Sports Medicine for providing medical care for us.
Talk about these coaches here. We're going to talk about them off and on here tonight. Mike Corson said 4 years. Here he is defensive coordinator for the team. Jim Spears is offensive coordinator. Mike Corson, he's legendary. He's been around over 40 years now that Mike Corson has been around. He has coached at Princeton, Campbell County, Roger Bacon, Mount St. Joe, and of course here at St. Bernard. And he's coached under some great people there. Pat Mancuso, who went to Roger Bacon, so he played with Ron Nabejevic. So he's one of his players there. And Dan Starkey, legendary coach at Roger Bacon. He was coach with him for a few years. And then when Dan came over here to St. Bernard to coach a few years back, he got Mike to come back over here. He got Mike to come back out of retirement to come here assistant coach. And then when Dan retired 4 years ago, Mike took over as head coach. So he's been around. Talked to him on the phone the other night. Great guy to listen to. He's got a great love for football and a great love for his athletes, that's for sure. There is Trey Jones. Trey Jones is hard to get come down here. I think it's Jones. We're going to see if that's number one or number six when he gets up. That was number six. Sorry about that. It's Miles Landry. Miles Landry had a nice little run back right now for about 20 yards. And they're going to have some fairly decent field position. Last time they did nothing. They had negative yards. So we'll see if the freshman Jaden Turner can do a little bit better now on this series of plays. And actually, we have a player down on the field here. So we have an official's timeout. So a little bit more about Mike Corson. And he was head coach at Campbell County for 5 years. And then, as I said, he was friends with Dan Starkey over here at Roger Bacon. He has a lot of connections with Roger Bacon. So, and he came back with him when Starkey retired. He retired too, went to Mount St. Joe for a year, actually went back to Princeton for 3 years. When he was at Princeton earlier with Pat Mancuso, Princeton won 3 state championships during his time with the Princeton Vikings. So he's been around football for 40 some years. And like I said, he has a fantastic knowledge of football, great love for the game. And he really likes it here at St. Bernard. He really likes these kids. I saw a little story on this. He didn't tell me this, but I saw a story on this that they call him Coach Uber because he takes a lot of his players home in his pickup truck sometimes. So, but he's a great coach. We'll talk more about St. Bernard's coach, David Poole, here in a few minutes. Meanwhile, though, North College Hill, the give is a sincere DeBose. They're doing some sweeps out of those with those receivers right now. And Turnage has not really attempted a pass yet. He was back in a passing formation and was sacked at the 3-yard line. So it's been all on the ground here, but it's all been negative yardage for the Trojans. So they're struggling a bit right now. Trips to this side, one single receiver, a back behind him. And the keeper is by Turnage, and he gets some running room and gets hit hard, but picks up about 5 or 6 yards. And that's your first positive yardage now for the Trojans tonight with 5:24 to go here in quarter number one. Skies are getting a little darker right now. And we said we're supposed to have a possibility of thunderstorms tonight. hoping to get this game in. Third game of the season for the Titans. The second game of the season, though, for the Trojans. They had their first game canceled because of a COVID case with New Miami, and they had to cancel that game, so they picked up a scrimmage game. And unfortunately, that's where Cameron Williams got hurt. Turnage. The give is to Miles Landrum, and Landrum's going nowhere. And actually, that was not Landrum, as to Trey Jones. To Trey Jones loses about 3 yards, and it'll be a fourth down situation. Mark Anderson's going to be coming in punting now again for the second time tonight. His first punt, he never got the ball because he was in the end zone and it was a safety. So Anderson is punting. And there's the kick. Hundley is back to receive. He's going to let it roll, though, and it gets a good North College Hill roll. Hits down at about the 25-yard line. Ball rolls right inside the 15, down to about the 12 or 13-yard line. So nice little roll here for the for Mark Anderson. It helps on the average a little bit. Picks up about a 40, and we'll count that as a 40-yard punt. So after getting good starting position on their first possession, now the Titans are almost backed up to their goal line here on the 13-yard line. That's where they'll get started on this possession. Came late here. St. Bernard scored twice, once on a safety, Botch snapped into the end zone on punt, and then Hundley the Wood, 26-yard touchdown pass. That's our 8-0 lead right now that we have for the Titans. Hundley gives to Thornton. Thornton, though, he's not getting anywhere. Thornton's down in the backfield. Thornton loses, let's see where they're going to spot the ball at. I say got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's at the 13-yard line. So second and 10 now, St. Bernard Titans. Game here on senior night, so far so good for him. Hundley back to pass, lobs it out, he's got a man, he overthrows Stanford just by a bit. Sorry, that was Wood. Wrong number three there. I have to switch my sheets around here. That didn't sound right. Jaden Wood. Coach Corson likes Jaden Wood out there. He feels that he's one of them. Good player for them out there. All right, third and 10 now. Let's see if Hundley's going to keep it himself. Does pitch, goes to Thornton. Thornton, 10-yard line, and he gets hammered at the 10-yard line. Number one on that play to Trey Jones for North College Hill. And so the pitch goes nowhere. It was kind of a high pitch, and the time he had to take that, North College Hill defense adjusted very quickly for it. So now we're going to have Isaac Drew. Averages about 25 yards a punt. He's going to be in his own end zone. Jalen Stanford and Demarion Joy are back just around the 46, 47-yard line for North College Hill, 2:23 to go. High snap, and we're going to have somebody jump to one side of the ball or the other. Let's see what they're going to call. Officials are going to talk this over. It's either possession or encroachment, or it's encroachment. So it's on the Trojans, so they'll get Right end was the one that jumped, according to Josh. Let's see if we see this. Yep, there he is. Well, that's a little bit better now for Isaac Drew. He's now at least out of the end zone. He's at about the 2-yard line and moves Stanford and Joy back about 3 or 4 yards. Good snap. Not a bad punt. And it is taken by Joy. Damarian Joy still running, still has the ball inside the 40, down to about the 37-yard line. Nice run back, but we have a penalty flag. Came in late on the play. This could signify maybe a hold. Let's see what happens. And it's a 10-yard penalty against North College Hill. See if we can see where this happened. Not sure where it happened at, but 10 yards back. 1:58 to go here in the first quarter, and North College Hill now gets its good field position here at the 48-yard line of the Titans. And Mike Corson's going to call a timeout. So Corson calls a timeout with 1:58 to go in this. It's Saturday night, so this is the only game on Saturday night in the MVC. Last night, Lachlan defeated Cincinnati College Prep 23-12. Summit 41, Cincinnati Country Day 7, CHCA 28, and Purcell Marion 6. And are you ready for this score? Most of you, if you follow football, you've seen this last night. On this field last night, St. Bernard was playing Norwood, which Norwood has a pretty good team this year. We know what St. Bernard has, or what Roger Baker has. They've got Corey Kenner. 82-28, final score, Roger Bacon over Norwood. That's true. 82-28, 62-20 at halftime. And a Kiner, seven touchdowns, 363 yards. A career game for him. We'll be seeing him in a few weeks, too. We'll be back here the first week in October for North College Hill and Roger Bacon. So we'll get to see him at that time. Yeah, big win for the Bacon. Roger Bacon and Purcell Marion now are playing full-time starting this year here in the MVC. And we got a nice run back here by and I didn't see the number of the guy, and that was number 26. He is not one of our regulars here. It's James Briggins. A 5'7", 165-pound sophomore, has a nice run back and has the Trojans' first down of the night here. With 1:49 to go here in the first quarter. Ball at 31-yard line. Turnage is yet to throw. And that's a high snap, and he's in trouble, but he gets out of that, and nice run back by the freshman. Runs right down the line, and he gets close to the first down. Let's see where he stepped out of bounds. They almost had him in the backfield. You can see that's number 61 right there. Eddie Clark almost had him in the backfield, but he squirted loose. He stepped out of bounds at the 25-yard line. So picked up about 6 on that play. Man in motion. He's going to keep it himself. This time, Turnage will get a first down, bounces off a couple of players, gets down to the 20-yard line, and the Trojans are in the red zone now with a new set of downs. So Mr. Turnage has rubbed off the rookiness there of the freshman quarterback, and now is looking pretty good on this series. A couple of runs here. Got a couple of first downs there, first downs of the night. Changing a call a little bit. Looks like he's going to be under center. And we got a motion. In the backfield, Briggins was in the backfield, and he moved. So that's 5 yards back now for the Trojans. Line of scrimmage now to 25. There you see Mike Corson. Turnage going to keep it himself again, and this time he does gets about 2 or 3 yards. He does not get back to the original line of scrimmage at the 20. He picks up maybe about 2 or 3, but it's going to be second and about, let's see where you're going to spot it. Looks like about second and 14. They have to get down to just about the 10-yard line, maybe just shy of the 10-yard line is where that marker is for a first down. Maybe have time for one more play in this quarter. Clock out under 20 seconds. Turner's going to keep it himself, and he kind of trips up a little bit, and that's enough for him, for the St. Bernard defense to have no time getting in and tackling him for a loss. As time runs out here in the first quarter, and it is the Titans up 8-0 over the Trojans. We'll be back for second quarter in just a moment. Don't go away.
Hey, sports fan! Did you know the OHSAA is among the national leaders in social media? Check out the OHSAA's social media platforms for news, tournament information, accomplishments, helpful links, and all the items available in the fan guide, including photos, DVDs, and publications. Check out OHSAA Sports on Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, and Instagram. And who knows? You may be the next featured face.
And Bill Brett's back here at Bron Bejtovich Stadium, home of Roger Bacon and the St. Bernard Titans, who are up 8-0. Thanks to a safety and a Hunley DeWoods 26-yard touchdown pass. And we come back here with the Trojans with the ball, third and long. It's a little, clouds are coming in right now, so it's a little easier to read their numbers right now. Turnage attempting to pass, and he is brought down big time. That's another sack right there, and that's by Kevin Benford. And that's it, and it's a fumble recovery. Hunley was the one who made the tackle, and a fumble recovery made by Armand Kahn, and St. Bernard takes over here to start this first quarter on a fumble recovery. Credit to Benford here. Great tackle. Ball got loose. Kahn was there to pick it up. So here we go. Line of scrimmage at the 28 now. Hunley. Man in motion. And that's who he gives it to. Number 31. It's Jaden Page. Page is in the sweep coming in from the receiver side on the left side. He loses a couple yards on that play. Clouds are coming in, and I'm trying to check my radar right now to see if we've got anything coming here that we should be concerned about soon. We'll give you your weather update here in a couple minutes. Meanwhile, second and 12 now for the Titans. Mokachil showing blitz, and that is partially blocked. That's blocked by number 33, T.J. Bolden. They were coming with a blitz, and I think that might have threw Hundley off just a bit. Looking at my weather radar right now, I do not see anything immediately in this area, even though it does look dark to the west. So we'll keep an eye out, see how this thing goes. Now it's going to be third and long now. To 26, they had to get out to the 38 yard line. Hundley back to pass, he's flushed out of the pocket, he's got a receiver down there, and he overthrows him. That was Jaden Page, was in the area. So fourth down, and that will bring Isaac Drew back on the field. He had a 40 yard punt last time. Nice job on the defense of North College Hill to flush him out of the pocket, and then battle for the ball. Nobody comes up with it. Isaac Drew, 40-yard punt for the senior the first time around. Line of scrimmage is at the 26. Stanford and Joy back now for the Trojans. They're moving back to about their 40-yard line. Snap back, he gets plenty of time, gets a nice kickoff, and that is taken by the Trojans, and battling up into St. Bernard territory. I think that was Joy that had that. So that's where the Trojans go to work here. They're down 8-0 in this game. Titans two scores, 9:52 to go in the first quarter, a safety, a bad snap in the end zone, and then Hundley the Wood, 26-yard touchdown pass, 6:31, actually on the next possession for the Titans. That's where we stand. And a give, and I tell you, that kind of developed a bit on the slow side, you might say. Turnage tried to hand it off to James Briggins. Briggins immediately taken down by the Titans. Among other players on that, as Amon Cohn was in on that tackle. Second and 12. Titans were shown blitz, but it's going to be an encroachment, so Mr. Turnage will get 5 yards unless he was drawn off. No, he wasn't, so 5 yards. The entire defensive line, it looks like, of St. Bernard was coming across there. So that moves the Titans, or Trojans, into Titan territory. And now it's second down and about 7. Turnage, snot in shotgun. He's looking to pass. He's got a man on side, and that is broken up by Wood. Wood came rushing in. is in position there and broke that up. He's 6'1", 190 pounds. He had a man open tempo. Did open, that was Kevin Braxton was open, but for a few seconds, but broken up. Third and seven. Turnage. Back to pass, and he is taken down. Number 50, Eli Miller. Sacked. Eli Miller, a senior. Has to feel good to get that sack on senior night. Nice coverage, though, by the secondary by St. Bernard. He had no place to go, and then all of a sudden he's got blindsided there by Mr. Miller. Fourth and a bunch. And it looks like Mark Anderson's going to go back and kick. And well, that was almost blocked. And the catch was made by Hundley, and I think he called a fair catch. I'm sorry, Wood, Jaden Wood. Wood, I think, called a fair catch, and that's why there wasn't any run back on it. I think he would look back on it now. He maybe would have second thought there, not called it, because he caught it on the fly there, and he could have picked up some good yardage. But nevertheless, St. Bernard will get good field position here with 8:45 to go here in the first half. They honored the seniors here, the senior football players, at before the game. At halftime, they're going to honor the seniors from St. Bernard in volleyball, cross country, and soccer. So, I don't know if there's going to be a discussion right here with the way these clouds are looking right now. Is they're going to maybe try to hurry up halftime here tonight so we can get this game in. We got a timeout, though. We got a timeout on them. Player on the field for St. Bernard. While we're doing that, there is the North College Hill huddle. And David Poole, he's in his first year as a coach at North College Hill, but people around high school football know a lot about David Poole over the years. So he was at Taft last year, defensive backfield. That Taft team was a great team the last two or three years. He also coached at Harmony School, the Harmony Academy. He's the one that started a football program there. And they were not a traditional high school football program. They actually played some college JV teams and did quite well over the years when he had nearly, I think, 60 kids get scholarships out of Harmony. It might even be more than that, but I believe 60 is what I saw. And Dave, of course, played in the NFL for a few years, Buffalo, New England, Miami. He played his college ball at Tennessee, and Carson Newman. He was All-American at Carson Newman. And there is a give is to number seven. And that's Miller, Greg Miller. Now, if you go way back in high school sports, you remember David Poole at Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education, CAPE? He was a three-sport player there. He went to the good track and field. I believe Cape was in the CHL for a few years before they disbanded. And I think he still holds some CHL records in relays. And Carlos So, Vinny Clark, great combination back during the 80s, 90s. Give us number 23, that's Benford. He gets about 3 or 4 yards. Going to be third and short. Actually, going back to David Poole, he played college, or he played track and field in college. He made a national championship in 100, 10.37. That's back in 1988. That's moving. All right, third and about three. Big play here for both teams. 7:25 to go here in the first half. And we got an official's timeout. It's a penalty against St. Bernard. False snap there. So they lose 5 yards, so it's now third. Instead of three, it's third and eight. Hundley. Play action. Goes to number 32. That is, for St. Bernard, that is Isaac Drew. Kind of a little trickery play, you might say there, because Drew is not normally in on some of the offensive possessions, but nevertheless, you get back to about the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be 4th and 10, and that's going to bring Isaac Drew back in to punt. Again, he's had a couple of good punts so far. Joy and Stanford back now for the Trojans. They're backing around the 25-30-yard line. Line of scrimmage is at 38. Drew, high snap, gets the kickoff. This one's a little short. And it's going to take a North College Hill bounce and picked up by number 12. That's, I think it's 12 or 14. Once again, those numbers are hard to see. That was number 12. It's Antonio Harmon. He's a junior. And what happened is nobody had touched the ball. It started going backwards, and Harmon wisely picks up the ball. Watch this. No, he's getting it. Everybody's kind of walking around, but Harmon picks it up and says, hey, I'm going to do something with this. And he does. Nice little 10-yard run back. He's hit hard out of bounds. He was actually kind of one of the up men. He was not one of the, because you could see Joy back there behind him. But a nice run back in the Titan territory. Mr. Harmon. And a timeout. Looks like Mike Corson called a timeout here for St. Bernard. It's the second one he has called. 6:16 to go here in the first half. Of course, I think everybody knows by now we're in our third week of doing ICRC football. We had a good one last night with Mason and Oak Hills. So we'll continue to have at least two games a week coming up here in the next few weeks. Of course, everybody knows the season's short. It's only 6 regular season games before the playoffs start. And essentially, all teams are eligible for the playoffs. Now, they get their choice, whether they want to do. They have to make the commitment, and the commitment has to be made by September 18th. Actually, I think it's midnight, September 18th, 17th. They have to make the commitment if they want to be in the playoffs. And then what they'll do is find out how many teams are going to be in the playoffs. That's how they get seeded in regions, and they'll do it just like they do in basketball, soccer, volleyball. They'll be seeded. No Harbins this year. And but teams do have the option not to be in the playoffs, and they can continue playing their regular season. So interesting flexibility, and I've talked to both of these coaches, David Poole and Mike Corson. They both like it. Turnage. Jones gets a little bit of running room inside of 45 before he's pushed back by the Titans. Picks up about 4 yards on that play. It'll be second and about 6, maybe 7. So North College Hill, a team that's over the last few years against the St. Bernard team, has scored a boatload of points and so far been shut out in this game. They have not played every year since they've gotten, St. Bernard's gotten football back in it. They've played 3 different times, including last year. Trips to his left, Turnage. And I think we're going to have somebody in the neutral zone. Let's see. Oh, they're going to wave it off now. Okay. No harm, no foul. So here we go. Second and about 7 now for the Trojans. Ball about the 45-yard line of the Titans. Turnage going to keep it himself. In a bit of a trouble. Now he's coming around the right side. And hit hard and taken down at about the 40-yard line. Zakeem Hundley was the first one that got to him. Wood was also on that. Picks up about 4 yards on that one. He said he wanted to try the commit going up the middle there. Didn't see any opening. freshman, came around the side, actually taken down by, looked like Eli Miller was also in on that tackle too. He first hit Hundley though. Number seven, like Sincere DeBrose, it looks like. That's DeBrose's. He gets the first down run, picks up about 7 or 8 yards. North College Hill, or St. Bernard, won in the third, so they will be getting the ball to begin this third quarter. North College Hill would love to score right now. And there is DeBose again, a penalty flag coming up here. Usually where that is thrown at could be a hold coming up on the Trojans. Let's see what the call is. Either that or face mask, depending on what they saw. It is a hold on the Trojans, so the ball is going to be coming back. It's from the point of... Let's see if we pick this up on our monitor here, where this hold was. I think that might have been it right as we just coming by there. It looked like a bit of on St. Bernard, or on North College Hill. Now they're marking it back, and like I said, it's from the spot of the foul. That's where holding is, so not necessarily the line of scrimmage. Although that was close to the line of scrimmage because they're now back at 28-yard line. First and 11 now for the Trojans. Turnings looking to pass. Overthrows his receiver. Jalen Stanford was his intended receiver, but he overthrew him. Watch Turnage warming up tonight and before the game. Didn't look too bad. You know, you got a first year coach here and you got a freshman quarterback now. For a senior who's been a veteran here. So it worked out for the Trojans here as we go through the season. Learning experiences for both. Turnings now in the shotgun, second and 11. Turnings back to pass, and he passes it in the middle of the field. There was no one there. Hundley with the interception, back out to about the 19-yard line. We got a penalty flag coming up, but for Hundley, that's his fifth pick of the year, and I don't know what happened. That somebody was not on the right page because there was nobody except Hundley in that area. We'll see this again. When you see it, you probably won't even see a North College Hill player even in the picture. We have a block in the back probably coming up here on the run back. It's on St. Bernard, but nevertheless, it's going to be the Titans ball though. Okay. Watch for number, Josh said watch for number 82. Here's the one he picked up on this. Now watch, they were following the receivers, but look, there's Hundley. And there's your block in the back right there. Although, it wasn't bad. I don't know. Didn't knock him out. Yeah, that was not a very stern one. Hundley. The give is to Thornton. And Thornton kind of rolls out over the 5-yard line. Their line of scrimmage was initially at the 4. They say he got out to about maybe the 6-yard line. Second down. Gives Hundley a little room now. At least now he's not standing in the end zone. Although Thornton is. Hundley, he's going to keep it himself. Hundley, around the left side, over the 10-yard line. Three 3:15 to go here in this first half. St. Bernard scored early in the game. There's been no scoring since the 6:31 mark of the first quarter. See Jason Carroll coming off the field here for St. Bernard. And a give is to Thornton, and Thornton back to about the 15-yard line. Did he get enough for a first down? And he gets enough. Frederick Rentlinger says he got enough for it. With Levi Lenny Thornton gets just enough of that first down. So a new set of downs for the Titans now. Thornton just pulling hard, trying to push, pulling the line across. Initially hit by Jones, but he gets a first down. Hunley, taken down for about a yard loss. And I say he got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's second and 10. Three seniors on that offensive line for the Titans. Penron, Cone, and Fleck. Junior and a sophomore, and Cooper and Wes. Hunley trying to be dragged down, and he is dragged down. And they call it a sack right there. Looks like the sack was credited to, I think it was Ryan Bolden. Let's see. Once again, it's hard to see those numbers. He gets up. It looks like it was Bolden. Ryan Bolden, 5'11", 205-pound freshman. Have a timeout, and I think the timeout is by the Trojans. Their first one here with 1:31 to go. Set up a third and long now. They would love to get the ball back here because they can hold the Titans now. They'll have a short field. They're not going to have a whole lot of time to get it done. Trojans 1-0 in the season. Titans 1-1. St. Bernard, after this game, going to road for three straight games, New Miami, Miami Valley Christian, and Norwood. College Hill will have two home games, CHCA, or one home game, CHCA. There's a pass, long pass going out, and we have pass interference coming up on North College Hill. Jaden Wood was being held up. Yeah, we have a flag. We actually have offsetting penalties here, maybe. So it could be a motion. That will probably offset everything. Talking it over right now, so see what the penalties are. It was definitely a pass interference. See if something happened before that. Okay, it's boss setting penalties, so we just play the down over again. It's the original penalty on the Titans, and then the Trojans pick up the pass interference, but they get a little bit of luck on that one. Oh, 1:26 to go. Third down and long now. Titans got to get out to about the 25-yard line for a first down. Zakeem Hundley directing traffic. Hundley, pass. And we have another pass interference on Wood. And this one I think is going to stick. Now, pass interference in high school is a 10-yard penalty, but an automatic first down. Of course, in NFL, you have to be at the spot of the penalty. But I thought it was first down, automatic first down. Let's see what happens. No, it's just a 10-yard penalty, but now it'll be no first down, but it was a 10-yard penalty, and you can see right there the interference. The interference looked like it was on Orlando Anderson, I believe, number two, a senior. All right. Running now, we're under a minute to go here. Center. That is broken up down there. Nice job by defense of White Hill. Ball with a halfback pass. Not a intended receiver was Wood. Go. Second down now. Cutchill showing blitz. Hundley picks up that blitz. Leads his runner out there and in and out of the hands. Tender receiver is Jaden Page, senior. Just off the tips of his hand. He was in double coverage down there. Nice job by Page, though. He didn't try to attempt that ball. Page. Just off the tips of his hand. So it is third now. St. Bernard's going to call a timeout. I believe both coaches now have called two timeouts here with 40 seconds to go in this first half. And look at our weather radar right now and see if we got anything to be worried about coming in here right now. And not see anything of significance in this area, so I think in Josh has got to, yeah, there it is. There you see the clouds there. We started off, we got here tonight. The sun was shining brightly. But the clouds have come in. He said it could hold off here tonight. So far, it looks like the worst weather here is still several miles away there. So there's your weather forecast for ICRC Saturday Night Football. Some senior shots there. The seniors get ready, as they said, at halftime. They're going to enter. To recognize the other seniors, volleyball, cross country, soccer, cheerleading. Forgot to mention cheerleaders earlier. They're going to be honored at halftime. All right, here we go. Third and 10. College Hill would love to get a stop right here, get a chance to get that ball back, maybe for a couple more shots at the end zone here before the half. And that is that's a wildcat play they had there. The Drew, Isaac Drew, snap went directly to him. He found a little running room over that left side where that big James Cooper got about 4 or 5 yards. Cooper, 6'5", 390-pound junior. I said 390, yes. According to coach, though, got good hands, though, and catch ball. I'm going to remind you back, remember a few years ago, when the clock runs out there, where Anthony Munoz caught a ball there, offensive lineman, for a touchdown. So maybe Mr. Cooper's time will be coming here. It is 8-0 in favor of the Titans. It is halftime. We'll be back for second half action. Don't go away.
The year was 1907. The Cubs won the World Series and the Ford Model R hit the assembly line. While here in Ohio, school administrators came together to form the Ohio High School Athletic Association. One thing that hasn't changed since 1907 is the dedication of the OHSAA to education-based athletics in Ohio. School sports teach responsibility, sportsmanship, and life lessons that stay with students long after their playing days are over. The OHSAA seeks to prepare students not for the next level of sport, but for the next level of life.
Hey, let's check out this park. Oh, wow, that's really cool.
To find a great local park or forest near you, go to discovertheforest.org.
100 years ago, the League of Women Voters was founded by suffragists who believed in the power of women to create a more perfect democracy. Throughout the last century, we've never stopped moving towards a future where every person in our country is empowered to play a critical role in shaping our democracy. Today, LWV activists throughout the United States are working to expand voting rights, ensure fair representation in government, and push for a more equitable and just political system. This progress is in our DNA, just as our founders did 100 years ago. Today, our activists are shaping the future of voting rights in America. See how their story could be yours.
What do you think you're doing, Kevin?
I was just going to drive home.
There are several warning signs present that you shouldn't be driving.
Like hearing voices?
Like your text to emoji ratio?
Oh, man, the selfies.
Selfie nailed it.
We all have warning signs that let us know that we're probably not okay to drive. Mine is pretending to be your subconscious.
Craig, come on, man, let's put a ride home.
I mean, I don't totally know what opioids are, but...
It doesn't happen here.
Not in denial.
No.
No.
Our kids are way too busy.
My son has good friends.
Don't live in denial, Ohio. Talk to your kids about drugs, and they'll be up to 50% less likely to use them.
I just wanted to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
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 Along the way, I'm learning
sportsmanship.
Sportsmanship.
Teamwork.
Teamwork.
How to work hard.
How to work hard.
Discipline.
Hustle.
Sacrifice.
How to be a leader.
Dedication.
I just want to play.
And along the way, I'm learning to put the team before myself.
To put the team before myself.
How to be a student.
How to be a student.
I'm learning
to set a good example.
How to work hard.
To accept responsibility.
That I represent my community.
That I represent my community.
I just wanted to play and look where it took me.
She's done it! Tiana Bartoletta has done it! From Elyria, Ohio, now an Olympic gold medalist.
And restore pride. We are people working cooperatively. Our typical client earns less than $14,000 annually and cannot afford the critical repairs they need to safely live at home, where they desperately want to be. Our services truly change lives, one repair at a time. Our professionally trained staff, along with 25,000 volunteer hours annually, has provided more than 280,000 services for low-income, elderly, and disabled homeowners in our communities. Every service makes an impact. Homes we service have an increased sales price of 10%, and even the value of surrounding homes increase upwards of 3%. Our energy conservation services save clients an average of $300 a year. These total savings from all customers equals over $200,000 in outstanding energy bills paid. With safer living environments, almost 50% of our clients reported improved health, and many are seeking medical attention less frequently. By living healthy at home, over $54,000 in state and federal funds can be saved annually for each client that does not need to move to assisted living. PwC's impact is more than just dollars and cents. Stable homes create stable families, which means children who are moving less frequently can achieve higher academic success. We are an investment in the future. More people living safely in their own home paints a brighter future for everyone, but we can't do it alone. We need your help to continue to build a brighter future for the entire community. Give back and get involved at pwchomerepairs.org.
When you vote, something powerful happens to your voice. Your single ballot becomes a megaphone. You stand out and tell your community and our nation what you want for our future. Vote411.org is your tool for accurate and unbiased election information on the issues that affect you and the people you care about. Through Vote411, you can register to vote using our online form that only takes a few minutes to complete, available in multiple languages. Check your registration status and find out where to vote right on the Vote 411 homepage and get important up-to-the-minute information on the elections happening in your state and local community through the Vote 411 interactive map. Your voice is strong and important. It is a critical part of our democracy. Vote411.org is your tool for all the election information you need. Get online, get the facts, and make your voice heard on Election Day. Powered by the League of Women Voters Education Fund.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother
you? So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
What to expect when you're expecting a teenager.
Today we're talking about how to wake up your teen, and this works literally every time.
Good kisses. Good kisses. You heard how loud
I know, I heard. I heard. It wasn't you. Yeah. It was the...
Is that bacon?
You don't have to know it all to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. This is a serious problem, but one we can solve. Visit feedingamerica.org to help. Together we can solve hunger. Together we're feeding America.
Get it.
She'll get it.
Get it. Get it.
When you bring home a Goodwill find, you give your whole town a reason to celebrate, because you're also funding local job training and placement programs in tech, healthcare, and more. Goodwill. Bring good home.
It's a beautiful day out here. Sunny today with light breezes, giving way to clouds in the afternoon. We could see some light precipitation to moderate precipitation later on, followed by powerful storm-like conditions. 90 miles per hour winds are expected. Authorities are asking everyone, stay indoors.
I just wanted to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
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 Along the way, I'm learning.
Sportsmanship.
Sportsmanship.
Teamwork.
Teamwork.
How to work hard.
How to work hard. Discipline.
Hustle.
Sacrifice.
How to be a leader.
Dedication.
I just want to play. And along the way, I'm learning to put the team before myself.
To put the team before myself.
How to be a student.
How to be a student.
I'm learning
to set a good example.
How to work hard.
To accept responsibility.
That I represent my community.
That I represent my community.
I just wanted to play and look where it took me.
She's done it! Tiana Bartoletta has done it! From Elyria, Ohio, now an Olympic gold medalist.
Sometimes the things we do or say can make others feel hurt, excluded, or isolated. Everything you say and do creates an impact.
How am I supposed to save the whole world?
You can't think about saving the world. You have to think about saving one person.
Because of you, someone's entire life can change. You don't have to be a superhero to have a positive impact.
Friends?
Friends.
I'll be right back.
Hi! You think you're probably sober?
Yeah.
But you're thinking about taking the back roads home, just in case. If you're probably sober, then why would you do that? Good choice.
Probably okay isn't okay. If you see a warning sign, stop and call a cab, a car, or a friend.
That's a full glass of wine. I'll be chatting you later.
I just wanted to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
I just want to play.
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 Along the way, I'm learning.
Sportsmanship.
Sportsmanship.
Teamwork. Teamwork.
How to work hard.
How to work hard. Discipline.
Hustle.
Sacrifice.
How to be a leader.
Dedication.
I just want to play.
And along the way, I'm learning to put the team before myself.
To put the team before myself.
How to be a student.
How to be a student.
I'm learning
to set a good example.
How to work hard.
To accept responsibility.
That I represent my community.
That I represent my community.
I just wanted to play and look where it took me.
She's done it! Tiana Bartoletta has done it! From Elyria, Ohio, now an Olympic gold medalist.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. This is a serious problem, but one we can solve. Visit feedingamerica.org to help. Together we can solve hunger. Together we're feeding America.
It's a beautiful day out here. Sunny today with light breezes, giving way to clouds in the afternoon. We could see some light precipitation to moderate precipitation later on, followed by powerful storm-like conditions. 90 miles per hour winds are expected. Authorities are asking everyone, stay indoors.
Come on, that's it. Let's go.
And Bill Brent's back here at Braun Bechtefitz Stadium in St. Bernard, where the Titans have an 8-0 lead at halftime. And I'm hoping we do not have an Al Roker moment here tonight in this game, because it is still cloudy, but we still do not show anything in a radar anywhere near the area. So hopefully we get the second half done, as the captains have gone out on the field right now for both teams. St. Bernard will be getting the ball to start this second half. Real quickly, the scoring, it's kind of simple so far. A safety when a bad snap from the end zone for the North College Hill punter gave St. Bernard a 2-0 lead with 9:52 to go in the first quarter. And then in the next series, on the kickoff then, in the next series, Zakeem Hunley found Jaden Wood for 26 yards for the touchdown. PAT was no good, so that's where the score is stands since 6:31 of that first quarter. So it has been 8-0 here. We'd like to thank, first off, we'd like to thank our ADs here tonight. For St. Bernard, Zach Stakely, he was busy down on the field with the halftime here. And I was wrong. It's not one volleyball and soccer. I guess they're going to be at another game. It was the cheerleaders in the cross country here tonight honored it at halftime. And also, Carol Anderson out at North College Hill. Both athletic director's been great with information for us this week. We'd like to thank them, of course. I'd like to thank Zach for being our host AD here tonight. Josh Stemstruff is back in the truck there with his crew here tonight, our great volunteer crew that we have with ICRC-TV. And someplace along the line here, we'll probably show you how, if you want to be part of all this, you can be. We always are looking for volunteers. ICRC Friday Night Football this week was Mason Oak Hills. I won't tell you the score of that game. I'll let you watch it. It's on ICRCTV.com. There we go. We need you. You can come out here, be camera personnel, work in the truck, work with Josh or Drew. And if you're interested, call our main man, Jason Dudley, back at ICRCTV, and he will help you out, because we're always looking for volunteers to come out. It's a lot of fun. Really is. And I always say, if it wasn't for these great volunteers, I'd be sitting here talking to myself, and that'd be really weird. So, Bill Bratz, glad you have joined us. You can see the crowd here tonight on senior night for St. Bernard. And the Titans have the lead, and they're going to get the ball back to start this third quarter. We'll be running back to those playback times at the end of this quarter. So here we go. Mark Anderson with the kick. And that's Wood, picked up the ball. He dropped it and then picked it back up and then was pushed back a little bit. So Jaden Wood, had a little bit of trouble with handling that kickoff. So St. Bernard's going to have a little bit of real estate here they're going to have to make up. They're going to get the ball, it looks like, at about the 18-yard line. And we have Zakeen Henley back there in the backfield. Zakeen Henley, he's 6'2", 180-pound senior. He does it all. He's on kickoff returns. He's on punt returns. He had a pick tonight. That's his fifth interception of the year on defensive back. A man that does not lead the field. And, you know, there's athletes like that. We have seen them, and especially in the smaller schools like that. And I really think these athletes just love that. They love staying on the field. They don't want to come off the field. Hunley. And the give is to Thornton, and Thornton picks up some nice positive yardage. Picks up about, it looks like, where his knee went down, maybe 4 or 5 yards on that. They're going to say four, so it'll be second and six. Oh, how about a gain of 3? Can't go much lower than that. I guess his knee went down. Second and 7 now for the Spartans. Well, the Spartans do play here. We'll see them in a few weeks. How about the Titans? The uniforms are very similar, too, by the way. High snap. Give to number 32. That is Isaac Drew. Isaac Drew's been on a few offensive plays. It's not listed on our kind of our depth chart here for offense for St. Bernard, but Drew is... had a couple offensive plays tonight, a couple of good plays. He comes off the field right now. So he picks up maybe, and I quite got back to about the line of scrimmage here. So it's going to be 3rd and 7 again. And College Hill would like a hold right here because they would have good field position, although they have not done much tonight with field position. Hunley, and we're going to have a penalty coming up, and I think it's going to be on St. Bernard. And I think we had a motion call here. So, ball now at the 22-yard line. And now it's going to be 3rd and about almost 12. See if Hunley will throw it on this possession. Hunley's going to keep it himself. Over the middle, over the 20-yard line, out to about the 21-yard line. It's going to be well short, 4th down. Isaac Drew is going to be coming in and punt. He's had a couple of good punts tonight. So the line of scrimmage is at the 21. Stanford and Joy back for the Trojans are standing right around the 50-yard line. And meanwhile, Isaac Drew standing in about his 7-yard line. Good snap. Plenty of time. Kick was not a good kick. And it's off of North College Hill player. That's off of Joy. But Joy did a great job of picking up some positive yardage. He got it about the 48-yard line. Tipped it a little bit, but ended up making some positive yardage. Had to work hard for that. Not a bad kick. And Joy tips it a little bit right there. Then he picks it up. Fortunately, he had no Titans in the area, so he picked up about another 10 yards or so. So good field position to 43-yard line for the Trojans. See if they can do something. Turnage is under center now. And down, a blitz coming in, and St. Bernard recovers the ball. Isaac Drew was one coming in on the blitz. Let's see if he's one to force the fumble, or because I don't think he picked it up, but I think he was the one that kind of created this. He came in unobstructed, and the ball squirts out, and the ball is picked up by it looked at number 53. who didn't have be Corey Thomas. So second turnover tonight for the Titans. The other one came on a interception. And that's Thornton in the backfield. Lenny Thornton gets hit, but then goes forward about another yard. He loses maybe about 1 yard on the play. Greg Miller coming in now. Mike Corson kind of mixing up those running backs back there in the backfield. And we got a timeout coming. St. Bernard's going to call a timeout, so that timeout is called by Mike Corson. They want to talk things over with. On a second and long situation here, 8:36 to go in this quarter, in the third quarter right now. Miami Valley Conference Gray Division action here right now. St. Bernard, as I said, they brought back the program back around 2011, 2012 in there. They were an independent at first, and then they joined the league in 2013. Since that time, their best record has been 4-6. They had a 4-6 in 2013 and last year 4-6. So they're looking for their first winning season right now. North College Hill, they've struggled in the last few years. They have not had a winning season since 2012. They were in the playoffs for three straight years, 2009, 10, and 11. They had a great team back during that time. ICRC covered them quite a bit during that time. They have been in the playoffs a total of six different times of a 2-6 record. St. Bernard has never made the playoffs, although they're planning to be in it this year. It's interesting because these teams have never made the playoffs. They're going to have their choice. They can be in the playoffs now this year. You don't have to qualify through Harbin's. Hundley lobs it up, and his intended receiver was Wood, and Wood just seemed like he was tripped up right from the beginning. He was not running. I don't know if he's down on the field right now. I don't know if he had an injury or not. Yeah, they're calling officials timeout. I don't know if we could see this again, but he never got up enough of steam there. If he was running full bore, he probably would have caught up with that. And if he would have, he would have been off to the end zone. But the trainers are coming back out. Let's see if we can see this replay again. Maybe not. All right, here we go. Josh, bring it up for us. Now watch and see if we could see him running. This is towards the end of play. See, he's not, it looked like he maybe got tripped up or something happened back there because he was not running down the field full bore. Now he's holding his right ankle, and now he's gingerly walking off the field. But to his credit, he's walking off the field. Now, I don't know. It could have been just a cramp out here. On a night like tonight, that could be very common. So he comes off the field, and that's a big loss for St. Bernard, not having him on the field. He's a leading receiver. He also does kickoffs, plays defensive end, so we'll keep an eye on him, see what happens. I don't know if it's just cramping up here, and he'll be back here in a few plays. I hope so. Long now, 3rd and 11 now for the Titans. They got trips to the left of Hundley. One single receiver to the right. He's looking left, screen pass. It's complete to Jaden Page. Page does not pick up much at all. He might have picked up about 2 yards. It's going to be 4th and 8. Now let's see if it's decision time. Will they go for the... Why is Drew coming back on the field here or not? He is. Drew is coming onto the field, so they are going to punt. See if this is going to be a real punt or not. St. going to enjoy back. It is going to be a punt. Gets a little bit of pressure and good kick. It rolls all the way back to the end zone. Now picked up near him. Now he can't pick it up in the end zone in high school football. 52-yard punt for Isaac Drew. He's saying by far his best punt of the season. And high school football, if it goes into the end zone, you can't pick it up and run it out. He kicks it way over Joy's head. Joy goes back. He's the one that goes back and chases it and watches it. And there it is in the end zone. He picks it up. The official says, nope, can't do that. Nice job by Isaac Drew. North College Hill now goes to work on the 20-yard line. A little bit of stoppage down here. I'm not sure what's going on, but now we're going. Turnage now in the shotgun. Blitz coming. He's going around the left side. Gets some bit of running room. And gets pushed forward out to maybe around 8-9 yards on that play. So it's going to be second and short. And I'm looking there. That is not Turnage, it looks like, at quarterback right now. That might be Demarion Joy. Holding call, though, against North College Hill, so it's going to bring that play back. That is Joy. Marion Joy, junior. So the ball spotted at the 10-yard line. It was from where the foul is. It's 10 yards back, so it's right at the line of scrimmage, so it's going to set up a first and 20 now. Just making sure everything is set right here. 7:29 to go here in the third quarter. This time, come running around the side here and taking out Joy, taking out of bounds. All the scoring in the first 5.5 minutes of this game, and since that time, it's been shutout. Ball spotted at the 23-yard line, so he gets some of those yardage back. Some of that yardage back set up a second and 12 now. And a give. So quarterback keeper. And we have a penalty coming in, a late penalty flag coming in, so this might be a little bit of extracurricular coming in on the. I believe that was Jones. See what the call is by the official. And who it's against. A lot of times when you see those late flags come in, it's just a little bit of extracurricular activity, you might say, going on in the field there. It's against North College Hill and against St. Bernard, offsetting penalties. So we just play the game over, the play over again. I'll get out. And I can't see what happened. Whatever happened, it happened afterwards. Didn't see exactly what happened there. Mike Corson, on-time coach. Blitz coming in now from St. Bernard. Picked up nicely by North College Hill, and he just drags the players ahead of him. And I think that might have been Joy. Let's see what happens. Did not see who the ball carrier was. We'll see if our PA announcer. We got a timeout for a North College Hill player down on the field. glare down on the field. And once again, I think this is, you know, with the temperatures, humidity, way it is here tonight. It actually has been a nice day today, generally speaking, but it's still a bit warm out here tonight. So cramping can come into the issue right now with these teams. When I said at the top of the broadcast tonight, Roger Bacon and Purcell Marion are now playing in the Miami Valley Conference, but just in football only. They do not play the other sports. The other sports are still in the GCL co-ed. It's just in football. Those two wanted to have a more competitive league for football. Norwood joined the league in 2017 along with Cincinnati College Prep. So this league has gained four teams since 2017. Norwood and Cincinnati College Prep are full-time members of the league. Norwood's had a tough time finding leagues. Ever since the Fort Ancient Valley League has folded, they've been trying to find leagues all over the place. They wanted to go to the CHL, couldn't get in there, was in the Southern Buckeye for a while. There's a quick kick here. Taking up, or Hunley's gonna just watch it roll. And falls down at about the 38-yard line. 36-yard kick. So St. Bernard will get the ball back here with 6:30 to go. Hanging on to that 8-0 lead that they've had. They lost to North College Hill last year, 48-22 back in 2016. North College Hill won 27-0, and in 2015, North College Hill won 48-13. They did not play any other years in between. Hunley, give his to Thornton. Thornton out to about the 40-yard line. Picks up about two or three on that play. As I said, we'll be back here in about two or three weeks. October 2nd, North College Hill will be back here at the stadium. This time they'll be playing the Roger Bacon Spartans. And that will be, I believe, a non-league game. I think because North College Hill is in the gray and Roger Bacon's in the scarlet. And I think when you cross divisions, it does not count as a league game. Of course, playoffs start the following week after that. Isaac Drew, down at about the 40-yard line. It'll be interesting to see what happens with the playoffs. And we got a now Roger Bacon player down on the field, and I think that's a cramping problem, too, on the field. At 5:37 to go. Yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see. It's going to be interesting to see what teams will decide to opt to go to the playoffs and what teams will decide not to, because the teams will be given the flexibility to go with the playoffs or not with the playoffs. So, and if they don't go with the playoffs, they can continue their season. They can run out their 10-game season. And here's the other little quirky things about playoffs. Let's say you are in the first, you're in the playoffs, you decide to go into it. First week you lose, or second week you lose, whatever it is. You still got a couple more weeks left, so you can pick up some more games at that time. Now, right now, nobody really quite knows who's going to be playing who, because we don't know who's going to be winning in playoffs, but it's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting for how some of these leagues are going to go. Of course, some of the, you know, most of the leagues right now are just playing all league games, and some of them aren't going to have enough. And I'll give you an example, Cincinnati Hills League, which we cover a lot. They have seven league games. They only have six scheduled. And the way the league bylaw says, if that seventh game can't be played, there is no league champion. Now, I don't know if some other leagues are going to have that situation, but it'll be interesting to see how it goes. And, you know, two teams from, you know, haven't played during the regular season from the same league, they meet in the playoffs, I guess they could count that as a league game. Crazy season we have here with football. But we're playing. That's the good thing is we're playing. There's Hunley. Hunley, there's Wood. He's being pulled down there, and that is going to be a definite, definite pass interference. He was being held onto by a North College Hill player big time. So, so that'll be 10 yards, and that'll be enough to give them a first down. Already starting to move the sticks here. And you see, watch him get his jersey. And hold on to that jersey. You can't hold on to the jersey. Not a good thing to do. Jalen Stanford is the one who was hanging on to that jersey there. Ball at the 45-yard line of the Titans. Thornton trying to run around the right side, and he is tripped up. And both of these teams have tried running around the corners and have not been successful at all, really, tonight at all. Just a couple of times they've had plays in which they've been successful. But for the most part, it's been tough running for the running backs here tonight.
Loss of two on the play. And I'll move it over to the 47-yard line. Second down.
All right, so second down. And about, he loses a couple, and that's a second and 12 now. And a scrimmage at 47. Hundley, back to pass. Unloads it. Got a player. He just out throws Jaden Page. Hundley got a good arm. Page could not catch up with it. Third and long now. Once again, we'll be running back to his playback times at the end of this quarter. You see Hundley just overthrew Page out there. We'll be running back to playback times for this game. Big third down play now. And Hundley is taken down. And that's going to count as a sack. His arm was going forward, and then he just kept on going backwards. And they're he's going to move the ball all the way back to into Titan territory. You can see the players are grabbing for the ball right there, and Sakeem Hundley comes off the field. Not too often he comes off the field. He does come off here because Isaac Drew's in the punt. Isaac's last punt, 52 yards. Into the end zone. Stanford and Joy back. Another fairly good kick. And this time is picked up by, looks like Stanford picked it up that time. Jalen Stanford caught it on the fly. Fairly good punt. But a good return now for the Trojans. 3:37 to go here in the third quarter. Trojans are trying to crack that score column. They did not score in the scrimmage game that they had at Doan Academy. That was back about 2 weeks ago, the game that they were going to play with New Miami, which was canceled. But they did manage to win last week. And they won in the fourth quarter last week. So let's see if they're going to be a fourth quarter team again this week. Turnage. Oh, he finds some good running room over the left side and is taken down by, he is manhandled by Isaac Drew. I tell you what, he went one direction, turned around, went the other direction, and picked up enough for a first down. It actually is going to count as about a 14-yard play, but I think he ran about 40 yards. And you see, he comes here, and he's almost tackled right there. Now, that's number 24. That's Martrice Smith. They keep throwing players in and out on us. Oh, he finds some good running room over the left side. And, we're back here again. Thank you. About 2 or 3 yards. Coach Poole keeps throwing me off over here. David's trying, you know, and I understand with, you know, the only one real game in on the season here, he wants to see what makes it work. He's a first-year coach. He's got to see what makes it work with these players. So he's thrown a couple of different players in. And that's Martre Smith. He's a sophomore. He's in a quarterback. Now he goes off the field. So shall we have a new quarterback? I think we do. I think it's going to be Marion Joy. He was in for a few series, so Durnich has not been in a while. Second and about five. Joy's going to take it himself. Find some running room. Closes up quickly. He goes out of bounds. He's going to be about 2 or 3 yards short of a first down. So it's going to be a third and short now for the Trojans. And we see it short. Going back the other direction and just slammed and knocked his. He got hit so hard his helmet came off. Wow. The Marion Joy was running one direction. He turned around and ran back the other direction and got clobbered by two or three St. Bernard players. Watch. Nope, make a decision there. Come back. And boom. And he's hit hard. It looked like number 53 might have been in on play. That'd be Corey Thomas. We have a timeout on the field, and I believe the timeout was called by North College Hill. Or actually, we got a player down on the field. That's why. We're going to take another look at that again. Watch him running direction. He's going to change directions, and he comes back. And there is the hit. Hit was actually by number 59. Armin Cohn is the one that got him. That helmet came flying off. Meanwhile, on the other side here, St. Bernard, Jaden Page was down on the field, and I think once again, it's probably cramping here tonight with this evening. That's not that hot out here tonight. Let's see what our temperature is here. It's 80 degrees now. It's not a whole lot of humidity. It says it feels like 86, but I don't think it's really that humid out here. But it doesn't take that much for cramping to happen with these players. And there is a long pass taken down, and that was, I can't see the player running off the field here and threw it. That's going to be a turnover on downs. Let's see who the quarterback's going to be. They've had a committee of quarterbacks here tonight. Anderson. Sophomore. He's listed as a quarterback. I think he might quarterback a lot on the JV right now, but he's one that has a nice arm there for a sophomore. So I tell you what, David Poole's having a committee of quarterbacks here tonight. Trying to find that solution to get the Trojans on the scoreboard. So far, they have been shut out for two-plus quarters. And that is a pass is complete. And that pass was complete to number 10, Jalon Parker. Parker picks up some nice yardage. First down for the Titans at the 43-yard line. And I think they want the, I'm not sure if they're looking up there. They want the clock to be reset down there. That's what the holdup is right now. The one official is telling the clock operator what to put the clock part, home to put it back at 150. So that's where we stand here. First down, and actually lost some on that yard. Oh. Bad snap. Hunley falls on it, though, very wisely. So kind of a wasted down for the Titans there. Second down. So we have 1:25. The clock is running right now. Titans are going the wrong way. Hunley, Thornton in the backfield, trips to his left. He's looking left. Now he looks right over the center. And Jaylon Parker was his intended receiver. I'm checking down here and seeing if he's had Jaden Wood back in the ballgame right now. I do not see Jaden on the sideline. And I'm looking for a number three on the field. Well, actually, he is actually out on the field. He's coming in. So Jaden Wood probably just had a... No, he's not. I think there's a little miscommunication right there. St. Bernard has to call a timeout. And I believe that is Mike Corson's fourth timeout. He will have one to go here, 1:08 to go. The team hanging on to an 8-0 lead as a result of a safety and a Hunley the Wood 26-yard touchdown pass. All came in the first 5.5 minutes of the game. Since that time, it has been a shutout here for both teams. College Hill coming off of a win. Both teams coming off of a win last week. St. Bernard would love to go the 2-1 right now, beat this rival team of North College Hill. We've got some CHL soccer coming up. I believe Josh said Tuesday night. We have Indian Hill and Marymount. Is that what you said? Yeah, Marymount's both teams. CHL is absolutely one of the best leagues for soccer around, especially Division II, Division III league. They've had several teams in the state rankings, including Marymount Boys are ranked number one in the state this past week. And I believe, Josh, that boys game or girls game we got coming up. We got boys on Tuesday and girls on Wednesday, so you get to see the number one Division II soccer team in the state playing on Tuesday on ICRC television. We got a lot of soccer. We got a lot of football. We got football next week. I got the week off next week. I'm a lucky one. I get a week off in the middle of the season. So, I guess of what you get when you've been around for a few years. You get to get a week off during the middle of the season. The ICRC football will be back. Hunley with the keeper on a third and long situation. And another player down on the field. So that is going to be fourth down. It's going to bring Isaac Drew back in to punt. Time is running out here in the third quarter. North College Hill, they have fourth quarter heroics last week against Cincinnati College Prep, largely due to Trey Jones. See if they have enough of it left this week. High punt gets a St. Bernard bounce and down to about the 35-yard line. 32-yard punt. 17 seconds to go here in the third quarter. College Hill have time maybe for one more play this quarter. Once again, hats off to our officiating crew here tonight. We'll say again, Frederick Brentlinger, he's your referee. Kevin Centers, James Marshall, Thomas Sempinski, and Mike Reed hats off to those guys. This has been a tough season for the officials and everybody. You didn't have any scrimmages or anything during the season. And I know that it's been tough trying to find officials, get full officials for the games. The signers have been doing a great job keeping these games going.
First down, no call Hill.
College Hill now with the ball on the downs. Ball 35-yard line. Didn't see who the quarterback is. Looks like our quarterback is going to be Anderson, Mark Anderson. For now. And it looked like Frederick Rentlinger called a timeout. Officials timeout. 17 seconds to go now. Anderson. The give is to Marion Joy. Demarion Joy gets some running room. 30, down about the 30-yard line. By far the biggest play of the night for the North College Hill Trojans. And maybe this kind of shuffling around of players, Coach David Poole, maybe starting to find a combination that works right now. Big play. It's about a 30-plus yard play. We're back to action already. And the clock runs out here as this time North College Hill does not get back to the line of scrimmage. Has Sincere DeBose with the ball. So we've closed out the third quarter. North College Hill is threatening now for the first time in a while. But 8-0 score in favor of St. Bernard Titans. All right, if you look at the screen long enough, you're going to get to see those playback times. I know you will. Josh is going to bring them up. Thanks to Josh and this entire crew. I've seen Kyle here tonight. Everybody have our A crew out here tonight as we have every night. There we go. So Monday playback, 9:14 on Monday. It's 8 o'clock p.m. Tuesday, Wednesday, 1:30 p.m. Thursday, 9:30 a.m., and we'll brunch in the morning with us. 9 o'clock on Saturday, and then 1 o'clock on Sunday. Now, that's on Spectrum. If you're in the communities of St. Bernard, North College Hill, Elmwood Place, Cincinnati Bell by Optics, wherever you get Cincinnati Bell, and, of course, you can always go to ICRCTV.com and see all of our games, including the Mason Oak Hills game from last night. Future games, including those soccer games this week, big soccer games this week from the CHL. So, thanks again to the entire crew. Thanks again, once again, to our athletic director, Zach Stakely here from St. Bernard, and of course, Carol Anderson from North College Hill. Appreciate all the help you have for us. You can go to icrcsports.com, find out all the different things going on. And then you can go to NBCSports.com, find out all about the Miami Valley Conference teams. We're going to see this play again. Look at that. Nifty running there by Mr. Joy. Finally brought down. Like Kevin Benford was when it brought him down. But not before you got a huge gain. Ball is going to be spotted at right now. I'm not sure what's going on right now. Isn't the ball at the 31-yard line? And all of a sudden we're at the I think we should be, yeah, you're right. We should have changed. Okay, this is weird. All right, no card sales still going the same way. Okay, and the ball is, I think that's Joy again. Actually, that was the quarterback right now, Mark Anderson. A guy we haven't called in a while is Miles Landrum. Think Miles, sometimes he lines up in that slot position out there. I'm pretty sure he's been on the field. And now I think what happened is they decided, wait a minute, we made a mistake here.
That was an untimed down because of a defensive penalty at the end of the third quarter.
Okay, so that play is not going to count at all. It's like, well, welcome back to the fourth quarter right now, people. So I don't think, I've been doing this for many years, I don't think I've ever seen that happen where they did not, they got it wrong. I couldn't figure out what in the world was going on here. But nevertheless, what can I say? Here we go. Now, I don't know, Josh, am I wrong? I thought the ball was on the 31. But now it's on the 17. So here you go. Yeah, to watch this game again, see how what happened there. But nevertheless, now they are going the right direction. And now we have start the fourth quarter. That play did not count. It's second down. It's second and about 11. They can get down to about the 2-yard line and still get another set of downs here. North College Hill trying to dent that scoring column for the first time tonight with a new combination in that backfield. And give is to Joy. Joy's got some running room, and he is knocked down about the 3-yard line. Look like a game or a touchdown saving tackle there by St. Bernard, but let's see if they've got down it. Yeah, they got down far enough. They've got a new set of downs down here. So North College Hill, after being shut out all night, finds a nice combination here with Demarion Joy and Mark Anderson. And Sincere DeBose, he's the one who carried there. Sincere down to about the 3-yard line. Well, without a listed field goal kicker, this is definitely 4-down territory. Now Joy is lined up on the left side, right side, wide receiver. A dropped, a bad snap, and picked up by a North College Hill player. And picked up by DeBose after a bad snap. And he manages to get back to the line of scrimmage. So now it is third and goal at the 4-yard line. This would be huge if St. Bernard could hold it. And that's Turnage back in the end zone. And he had a player wide open in the end zone, and he fell down. Oh my, Juan Wagner, the junior. He was in the back of the end zone. Nobody was there. Let's see if you can see it happen actually right as he's right about now. He's there and he falls, he slips. A sure touchdown pass. Now it's fourth and goal at the 4-yard line. Four straight across the board here because we're in the fourth quarter. Huge play for both teams. And Turnage is back at quarterback. Turnage back, passes, and it's no good, and St. Bernard holds on a huge goal line stand and takes over on downs. Wow, that wasn't even close on that pass. That might have been Antonio Harmon. I see a 12. That might have been Harmon at quarterback. Nope, that was Turnage. And he was not anywhere close. It was for DeBose. He just really threw it quickly. I mean, he had the pressure on him. Antonio Harmon was the intended receiver. So, at the 4-yard line, Zakeem Hundley goes to work here now. And has a hard hit on Thornton. Right about the 1-yard line. Detre Jones, he was the hero last week for North College Hill with a kickoff return and then an eventual touchdown for the winner. He had a huge hit on Thornton now. The ball is at about the 1-yard line. And Thornton gets a little running room out to about the 2 or 3 yard line. Actually, as Isaac Drew.
Isaac Drew, the ball carrier. Ian Keen to play. The ball at the 4-yard line, third down.
And they spotted at the, they say the 4-yard line. So right about where North College Hill gave up on the downs there. It's now third down for the Titans. And the give is to, I believe, Hundley. It was Hundley. And we got some extracurricular happening after the play here. The flag was thrown after the play was over. Hundley got maybe out to about the 10-yard line. Let's see what happens, who is going to be called on. Bit of a rivalry between these two teams. Unsportsmanlike, and it's against North College Hill. That's a big, big play. It's a first down for St. Bernard, and it gives them 15 more yards. That's huge for the Titans. Because the clock now is on their side. And some of these players, even though, you know, we're in St. Bernard down here, North College Hill, about 2-3 yards. 2-3 miles away here. These players know each other. I believe Williams went to the school here in his freshman year, and maybe his junior high year, so the players know him. Hundley being flushed out of the pocket. He throws short. And Woods slow getting up again, and one of the coaches helps him up there in the sideline for him. He got flushed out of the pocket. It's number 26, James Briggins. 8:43 to go. Ball at the 25-yard line. Hundley again. Hundley now gets a little bit more running room, stays in bounds, gets out to about the 37-yard line, and that's going to be enough for a first down. Nice job by, nice run by Zakeem Hundley. This is where your senior pays off. He knows where he has to go. He steps one way, tries to get out, was going towards out of bounds marker, but stayed in enough to get that first down. Ball out to the 31. And remember, they started this at the 4-yard line and actually got backed up to the 1, and now they're out to the 31. Thornton still on his feet over the 40, out to about the 42, 43-yard line. Nice pickup by Lenny Thornton. Senior running back picks up about 6-7 on that play. Give him 6. Now right now, St. Bernard wants to see that clock run and run and run, because it is on their side right now. Although this North College Hill has shown they can strike quickly as they did last week. Hard count. Thornton again. Thornton, little spin move, and now they drag him back. Ball is loose, but he was down. He was already down on the play, so it will not count. He did not. Well, they're going to give him a yard. That's a hard-fought yard. See, Timothy Smith is one of those players in on that play for North College Hill, the senior. Third and short now. They have to get to the 46 for a first down. Hunley going to dive for it, but he's going to be short about a yard. Let's see now if the Titans are going to go for it. Or see Isaac Drew started in talking to the coaches now. I think they might want to talk this over. Drew's coming off. I think they're going to go for it. They are going to go for it. It's fourth and short. Kind of a risky play right now because they are in their own territory. I think what happened is, even though he's a good punter, I think they need to hang on to the ball. They want the clock to be on their side, and there you go. They might have gotten it via penalty. Good move by Mike Corson to keep him on the field, and Zach Hunley for the count right there that threw North College Hill off. Encroachment, 5 yards, first down. Ball out the 49-yard line. 5:45 to go in the game. I really think right now, you look back on it, if they win this game, that might have been where the game was won, staying on the field. As long as they can keep the ball on the field. And that's a big hole, though, for Lenny Thornton. He's out about 8-9 yards. Going to be a second and short. Into Trojan territory now. There's Mike Corson. There's Lenny Thornton. Second and three. Hunley take as much time as he can right now. He's trying to really milk that clock. Thornton, he's got a first down out to around the 40-yard line. He had to get to about the 38, 39, but he looks like he might have made it. It is a first down. More importantly, that keeps that clock running. So right now, Zakeem Hunley is using all the time he can on the field. Over talking on the sideline to the coaches here. Offensive coordinator is Jim Spears. Mike Corson is the defensive coordinator. Hunley going to keep it himself, but he's dragged down for a big loss. Dragged down by number 53, Christian Stanley. They're going to call it a sack. I'm not quite sure if it really is a sack. I guess it is. Call it that. So a little bit of a setback here, but nevertheless, the clock is going down to around 3:35 to go here in the game. Titans holding on to a slim 8-0 lead. Hunley, back to pass. Got a man, had a man part a little bit open. Now it was Wood, his favorite receiver, but he threw the ball out of bounds. He's getting a little bit of pressure on him. That does stop the clock. 3:22 to go. Titans trying to move to 2-1 on the season. 2-1 in the league. Tie them with Lachlan's wins, but Lachlan is actually 2-0 on the season. Hunley's going to keep it himself. and kind of pushed forward a little bit there by the North College Hill, almost back to the line of scrimmage. And North College Hill is going to call a timeout here. It's fourth down, and it's fourth and long. So David Poole wants to talk this over and see what they're going to do. David Poole, a great defensive back himself in college. He's a defensive back and receiver in college. Went to Tennessee in his freshman year. Carson Newman his next 3 years. Played in NFL from 1990 to 1994. Defensive back. 1992, got a pick six in the NFL. There's something you can remember all your life. Played for Buffalo, New England, Miami. Been around coaching in Cincinnati area for many, many years. Came to here from Taft High School where he was. And, of course, Taft Senators have done very well in the playoffs the last few years as one of the better teams in the playoffs. So he's come from a good program that he's coming to, and he's coming to North College Hill, which last year they were 5-5. They had a couple of off years before that time. And I said the last time they had a winning season was back in 2012. They were 6-4 that year. And then previously, 2009, 10, and 11, they were in the playoffs for three straight years and had a very good team going on at that time. They were league champs in the NBC, undefeated for two straight years as league champs. So, actually, three straight years they were undefeated. Now College Hill's in the Gray Division. The Gray Division has Lachlan, St. Bernard, Cincinnati Country Day, Cincinnati College Prep, New Miami, Clark Montessori, and Miami Valley Christian. Player off the field here, and he's going to get off here before that clock runs out. High snap. Here comes the kick. And it's a pretty good one. And taken, immediately taken down. Wood took the punt return. That was Joy. Wood was right there. Took Joy down at about the 8-yard line. So 30-plus yard punt. For Isaac Drew, he's had a great night in punting. He's done a good job. If you're going to look for some keys of winning this game, his foot has been one of them here. He's pinned North College Hill a couple of times deep in their territory, including right now. So now the Titans have 92 yards and 3 minutes and 2 seconds to go. Get a touchdown. And even that's not going to guarantee it because they got to get the 2-point PAT. They had some heroics last week. Let's see if they have any left over for this week. And that is quarterback Anderson, and Anderson is hit hard at about 7 or 8 yard line. Good coverage by St. Bernard's secondary. He couldn't find a receiver open, and he started scrambling, and they were right on top of him. He's looking. You see, looking two different directions there. Had all his receivers covered. And then kind of gang tackled by the Titans. Ball still on the 8-yard line. That's to Trey Jones is in that backfield. There's a pass, and it's intercepted. Intercepted and ran into the end zone by Jalen Parker. And that could be a coffin biter for the Trojans. Ball intercepted and ran in by Parker. So Parker with the touchdown gives St. Bernard a 14-0 lead here with 2:07 to go in the game. Caught the ball at the 19, so we'll give him 19 yards on that pick six. Now That's one happy young man there. We'll see it again. That was an easy pick six for him. They're going for the 2-point. Hundley turns around. Has a man open. He was double covered in the end zone. And that was, of course, Jaden Wood, his favorite receiver. But nevertheless, 14 to nothing is the score. So right now, the St. Bernard defense is pitching a shutout. They pitched a shutout last week. They're trying to go for their second straight shutout here of the season. Get their second win. Yeah, I talked with Mike Corson on the phone the other night, and he was very excited about the season. He said this is first off, it's the most seniors he's had, and then the most experience he's had, because he said most of these seniors have played together. There's 13 of them listed on the roster there. Most have played together since their freshman year, and he was pretty excited about this team. And he had some depth here at some positions. He's shown that tonight. He's had Greg Miller and Kevin Benford in as running backs, both of them seniors, along with Lenny Thornton. So Titans trying to move to 2-1 on the season. St. Bernard will be at St. Bernard's schedule. St. Bernard will be at New Miami next week, then at Miami Valley Christian Academy 2 weeks, then they'll finish up their regular season on the 2nd at Norwood. And the punt is taken, and the kickoff is coming back other direction, and that is number 3. That's Jalen Stanford. He's taking it to the house. And just like that, North College Hill offset that touchdown with a kickoff return. And finally, the Trojans get into the end zone as a St. Bernard player is back here at about the 45-yard line. So we're going to hold off here before we get the point. We're going to have a couple of different looks at that kickoff return. So we're going to call it 78 yards. And really, he had one player right there, and that was it. And I think that's a player that got hurt. And he was off to the races here. How about Jalen Stanford? Well, last week it was DeTre Jones with the kickoff return for 48 yards. This week, Parker, 78 yards. The old expression of the great Yogi Berra, it ain't over until it's over. 1:53 to go. You kind of think right now that North College Hill might be trying an onside kick. Let's see what happens on the PAT. Obviously, it's going to be a 2-point PAT. Stanford with a 78-yard kickoff return. 1:53 to go here in the game. Turnage in at quarterback. The freshman, he started the game tonight. David Poole's had a host of quarterbacks there. Turnage now looking. Is he going to take it himself? Let's see what happens. Into the end zone, in and out of the hands of Joy. So North College Hill does not get the PAT, but this game's not over yet. You got to think that the Trojans are going to try an onside kick here. I think that the Titans are thinking that's what they're going to be doing. You can see some of our people up there from ICRC-TV. Big man Josh, my guy Bill's I'm all by myself in the 10 here. Good to have Kyle Evans back with us here. Sweet. Thanks to our great camera personnel, all the personnel that we have. Guys do a great job out here. All right, let's see what happens. Let's see. Well, I think they're looking for it. Will it be an onside kick? I think everybody in the stadium thinks the same thing. Let's see if North College Hill thinks that way. It does. It's bounced up and it is taken by the Titans. It is recovered. They kind of had their hands team up there. They have Wood up there. He was the one that Jaden Wood got it. Coach Corson gave him a nice compliment the other day on the phone. He says, Jaden Wood's a great leader out there. He's like having a coach on the field.
First down and eight from the 49-yard line.
So 49-yard line now. 1:52 to go in the game. College Hill tried the onside kick. Wood recovered. Now St. Bernard goes to work. I would say if they can keep that clock running and get a first down, I think they've got this one locked up. Got to get that first down first, and they're not going to get it that way.
And he Thornton's a ball carrier.
Thornton's a ball carrier, and he was several Titans hitting there. Jones, among others.
Timeout, North College Hill.
North College Hill's going to call a timeout. Now, if my numbers are right now, I believe each coach has a timeout left in this game. 1:38 to go. St. Bernard doesn't have a shutout tonight. They do have the lead. And that's going to be as important, if not as more important. Once again, stay tuned to ICRC-TV for a lot of sports action coming up here in the next few weeks. A lot of football coming up. As we said earlier, we have some soccer games coming up here from the CHL this coming week. Don't know if we have any volleyball set up yet, but we might wait till tournament time for that. 2 weeks we got one. Is that Keem Hunley back to about the 45-yard line. Now North College Hill has called a timeout, and if my numbers are right now, I think that is their final timeout. If not, they have one more. Well, Josh. So 1:39 to go. It's going to be third and long. If they can stop them on this play, they have a chance to get that ball back. And you can see what they can do. They can strike quickly. But really, right now, they are a touchdown and a two-point PAT away from tying this game.
Ball placed in the 45-yard line. It's third down.
Third and long now. Hunley under center this time. That's because he's trying to push it ahead. He got back to the line of scrimmage. Now, I would think right now you bring in, you bring in Isaac Drew, because he's had a great night in punting. Foot to pin the Trojans back deep in their territory. He's had some big kicks tonight. This will be the biggest one yet. And special pressure here in this offensive line. They've done a good job tonight of protection for him. And St. Bernard's going to call a timeout.
Timeout times.
And if my numbers are right on that one, I know, Josh, you concur with me. I think we're out of timeouts here tonight. We used them all up tonight. So we have no more timeouts left in this game. 53 seconds to go. And a big punt coming up. You wouldn't think there'd be a trick play at this point in time of trying to keep it. Because if it was fourth and short, I would say you could have a possibility of that. We're fourth and 11. And I think Isaac Drew's going to have to kick it. But he's going to have the kick of the season here for him. And then special teams, the pressure on them to keep a punt return coming for North College Hill. North College Hill is hoping for another week of miracles. Low snap. Kick was almost blocked. Another really good kick, and he gets a good bounce, gets a great roll. Now it's picked up by North College Hill, and he's got some running room. He's got some big-time running room around the right side. Still on his feet, and finally down. See who that was. Was that? That was Stanford. Jalen Stanford, the senior. It looked like for a second he might let it roll, but then he picked it up, and there was no one nearby. Watch when he picks it up. Looks like he was stopped, and then he took off running, and he had nobody over on that right side for several yards. Look at this. He didn't get a player. He almost went 30 yards before he even had a player. I think he ran into his own player. So we got 33 seconds to go. Is there a miracle tonight in North College Hill? We will find out. Let's see what our quarterback by committee will be tonight. Looks like Stanford is quarterback. And he's keeping the ball himself. Now he's looking to throw. He throws it downfield. He's got a man open. And he is down. Great pass. That was Sincere DeBose. And the pass was from Jalen Stanford. He was almost down there, and look, he threw a great pass into coverage, and still a great pass made by DeBrose, and ball at the 25-yard line, 12 seconds ago. He's going for the end zone, and it is picked off by the Titans. The ball out at 82, number 82, Jason Carroll. We haven't called his name tonight, but it was big now. There are 2 seconds left on the clock. A huge interception returned by Jason Carroll. And basically, 2 seconds ago, Hundley takes a knee. The Titans get a big win here. And he threw it, he really didn't have a player close to it, but. Carroll, a junior, I think we called his name all night. This is receiver and defensive back, but a huge, huge play. After North College Hill got a big play previous to that, get him down to the 25-yard line. Hundley just takes a knee, and this is over. And the St. Bernard Titans come up with a huge win as they hold off North College Hill by the final score of 14-6 here tonight. A safety in the first quarter. Hundley the Wood touchdown in the second quarter. Or in the first quarter also, made it 8-0. No scoring again until we had Jalen Parker, 19 yards. 2:07 to go, making it 14-0. And on the ensuing kickoff, Jalen Stanford takes it 78 yards. Their PAT was no good. And that's how we end it, 14-6. The Titans moved to 2-1 in the season and 2-1 in the league. North College Hill drops to 1-1 in the season, 1-1 in the league. For the entire ICRC staff that's been out here tonight and all the volunteers and all the guys back at the studio, and particularly our main man, Josh, this is Bill Brett saying goodbye from Braun Bechtovich Stadium.